நீயில்லாத நாளல்ல நாளாகுமா நீயில்லாத வாழ்வல்ல வாழ்வாகுமா
Book of Acts chapter 5 verse 2 With his wife's full knowledge he kept back part of the money for himself and brought the rest and put it at the apostles' feet The early church people sold their belongings and properties and put it at the apostles' feet Everyone gave everything and commonly benefited from it Among the many who gave the Holy Spirit led to record two instances particular First one was Barnabas recorded in Acts chapter 4 verse 37 He sold his field and put it at the apostles' feet Now Ananias and Sapphira saw what Barnabas did and wanted to do the same because they wanted to be seen as good as Barnabas. Ananias and Sapphira lived a life comparing with others. They always wanted to be better than others, always wanted to be seen more spiritual than others. Fortunately, their deceitfulness was exposed thanks to the act of Barnabas who gave for the Lord. Because Barnabas gave, Ananias and Sapphira also came forward to give, of course with wrong intention, kept back a part and exposed themselves as deceitful people. Let me encourage you all, dear people of God, let us be true, let us walk upright, and through that God will expose deceitful people. Yes, we should walk upright. When Barnabas was upright, deceitful people were exposed. We have to understand that it wasn't wrong or it wasn't a sin when Ananias and Sapphira kept back for themselves. The apostles did not force them to give. So keeping back for themselves wasn't a sin. But the fact that they acted and pretended as if they gave everything was a sin. Keeping back wasn't a sin. But pretending like they have given it all was a sin. They had enough faith to sell the properties but didn't have enough faith to bring it all and give to the apostles. They slipped there. What was the outcome? They fell dead on the spot. We are untrue to many people. We are untrue to even God sometimes. And if we are still alive, it means God by His grace and granted us mercy to live. We shouldn't take that grace for granted. Today examine your heart. In what things are we being deceitful? Which of our actions hurt God? Examine. Realize we washed in blood of Jesus Christ. Just say like how Isaiah said, Oh, I'm ruined. Submit yourself to the Lord. Remember how Isaiah's tongue was cleansed by fire and was lifted up as a mighty servant of God. Likewise, may the Lord cleanse us also and do great and mighty things through us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you.